In the previous session, we learned how to connect to PostgreSQL using the command prompt or terminal. Today, we will do the same thing, but using VS Code instead. So without wasting any time, let's get started.
To connect to PostgreSQL, you need to have VS Code installed properly on your machine. This applies to any operating system, including Windows, Linux, or Mac. I am assuming that you already have VS Code installed. If so, please open it now, because we will need to install some plugins. Here I have my VS Code opened. Now that you have VS Code open, please go to the marketplace and search for the extension called SQLTools. Make sure to write SQLTools as a single word without any spaces. Here it is. Install it once you find it. I will leave the link of this extension in the description. After installing the extension, you should be able to see it in the extension bar on the left-hand side of your screen. It will have an icon that looks like a database. We are not done yet. Now we need to install drivers for PostgreSQL. To do this, go back to the marketplace and search for SQLTools PostgreSQL. Both the SQLTools extension and the drivers are from the publisher Matheus, Teixeira. However, I will also leave the link to the driver in the description for your convenience. Anyways, here is the driver. The full name of the driver is SQLTools PostgreSQL Cockroach driver. Install it. Done. Once the driver is installed, go back to SQLTools and click on Add New Connection. Then select PostgreSQL. This will open the Connection Assistant form, which we will need to fill out. We will be using the information from the installation string that we used in the installation video to do this. Okay, let's start. Connection name. You can name your connection whatever you want. I will name my connection as Postgres. Connection group. Leave it empty. Connect using. Leave it set on server and port. Server address. Since my PostgreSQL is installed on this same machine, thus I will leave it set on localhost. In case you have installed your PostgreSQL on a remote server, then put the IP address of that server here. Port. If you remember, while installing PostgreSQL, we exposed port number 5432 for the installation. 5432 also happens to be the default port number for the PostgreSQL. We will use the same port number, 5432. Database. Here we have to put the name of the database to which we want to connect. After installation of PostgreSQL, we will be provided with a default database whose name is Postgres. This name is case sensitive, so make sure to type it in all small letters. Username. Similar to database name, with the installation, we are provided with a default user, again whose name is Postgres, all in small letters. Use password. For the time being, I will set this value to save as plain text in settings. This is not recommended. Usually we set it to ask to connect. On doing so, you will be asked to put the password every time you will connect with the database. Password. Here put the password of the database. This is the same password you assigned while installation. In my case, it was Postgres. That's all we have to do. Leave the remaining fields set on their default values. Now press test connection. Oops, I got an error. This is because my Docker container for Postgres isn't running. Let me run the Docker container. Here is my Docker desktop app. And here is my Postgres container. Let's run it. Done. Now let's test the connection once again. successfully connected. Next, press the Save Connection. And then from the connection panel, select the connection that you just created and right click on it and select Connect. In this worksheet, you can write your SQL queries and run them. Let me show you how. Let's write a query to check the current username with which we are connected. To run this statement, press the Run on Active Connection button. And here is the result, which is Postgres.
That is how we connect with the PostgreSQL server using VS Code. That's it for this tutorial. Hope you enjoyed watching it. If so, then give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.